know the guy who made us, but us and plus he made us.
You need to jump down. We got the two kingdom you want down. All that confusion you can dump down. We remember Jesus till he come back.
Let's go with Dominic. Don't I have two Dominics?
Yeah. One.
How's it spelled?
Which one has a C, which one has a K?
I have a C.
Dominic with a C. Come up here and I want you to name the line segment.
You got this, Dominic. Just grab what you put there and we'll help you fix it.
I don't even have my paper. I forgot it.
You don't need your paper for this.
I don't have my notebook either. I took it out and forgot it. All right, so we're going to switch to Dominic with a K. It's a joy about having two Dominics. Well, there's always the plan B. Well, I got my line. I got my paper. Line segment says part of the line and C, A, D, and D, A. Name it. Write it. Very specific. We have to be very precise in this classroom.
I really don't care about my handwriting.
We all have bad handwriting.
Okay, so I did have handwriting. That is right.
All right. Thank you, Dominic. Raise your hand if you agree with Dominic. Raise your hand if you disagree with Dominic. Why do you disagree with Dominic?
On a line segment, you only want to put two points and then put a line over it.
If we have our notebook, this is why we have a notebook. This is why we take notes in our notebook. Because if you turn back one page where it says naming, and then you go to line, it says how many letters?
Two.
So any line whatsoever, if you put three or more, that is not a line. Plus, what else does it say? With the correct symbol. What's the symbol for a line segment?
The line
with no arrows. So if we just erase one letter, will that work? Or CA?
So I did.
Is it A and N?
CA, if you look at CA, and I drew a line right here, is CA a line segment? Do you see the line that goes from C to A?
Yes.
Starts at C, stops at A.
Yes.
It's a line segment. Does it continue farther than C to A?
No.
Does it go past C and past A? Yes. But as soon as I write this, it does not. Sir.
Exactly what I have.
This is what you have? That's disappointing.
It is.
That you sat there and said you didn't have it right when you had it right the whole time.
It is.
You gotta believe in yourself. This stuff isn't hard. What about DA? Is DA a line segment if I do this?
Yes.
Yes. That's it. Are those the only two line segments out there?
No.
No. EA? I can reverse these letters. It could be AD. It doesn't matter. It could be AC. BE is a line segment. EB is a line segment. I could say line segment CD. That's a line segment. Alright, let's see who has a ray. Renee, where's Renee? Renee, a ray. Thank you, Renee. Raise your hand if you agree with Renee. Raise your hand if you disagree with Renee. Why?
You wrote the arrow the wrong way.
She wrote the arrow the wrong way. Is the arrow the wrong way?
No.
No. It's
the right way.
You mean one
for Renee?
What?
Oh, wait. The plus.
Does the ray go to the left?
Yes.
Of course the ray goes to the left. Does this arrow represent what direction the ray is going?
No.
No. The notation always goes to the right, no matter what direction your ray is going. The list, how you list the letters determine which direction your ray is going. Now, we just saw when we did line segment, every single line needs how many letters?
Two.
Does that work?
Yes.
That works. The way you list your letters tells everybody what direction your ray is going, because you always start, your first letter is the starting point of your ray. So she wrote AE, so if I go from A to E, and it's a ray, so does it keep going in that direction? Yes. There you go. You're done. Is that the only ray up there?
No.
No. That same ray, I can call it AB. I can call that EB. There's a ray that's AC. The ray AD. This ray DC. That ray CD. They're all rays. One special case. You see how this is a solid line that goes into a dotted line?
Yeah.
When you see that, that means that that line is not sitting on top of the plane. That means that that line is going through the plane. The solid line's on top, the dotted line is what comes out the bottom. We'll go with that?
Yeah.
Because that's a three-dimensional shape that they're going to show you on a two-dimensional plane. And that's how they tell you. Alright, last one. Plane. Nazir, can you name the plane for me? Am I saying your name wrong, too?
No, you're good.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Is that correct?
Let's find out. Who agrees with him? He wrote AEF. I have people wanting to agree with you. Why aren't you though? Who disagrees? Why? That's it. This is great. AEF, 3 points inside the plane. The only thing you're missing is, if you leave it like that, all it is 3 random points. You have to write the word plane in front of it. You write the word plane to tell everybody that's what you're trying to represent. You're representing the plane, plane AEF. Perfect. We're going to find out today why naming is so important, because if you know how to name, then you know how to read the name. And you're going to have to be able to read the name all year long. The definition at the bottom. Definition of a circle is a set of all points in space equal distance from a single point called the center. Is that true or false, and why? Darvis? That's true. Who agrees? It's true. Who disagrees?
Not many disagrees.
Why? Perfect. Perfect. It's not in space. In space is three-dimensional. In space means this is a sphere, not a circle. It has to be in a plane. Plane is two-dimensional. Plane would be the circle.
If you get it wrong, don't erase it. Just put a line that you got it wrong and then fix it.
All right, now we're going to take notes. Turn to the next page in your notebook, which should be page, what?
7.
We're going to take angle addition and segment addition. Angle addition and segment addition postulates. Alright. A postulate is a given statement of fact. I'm going to give it to you. The definition is going to be given to you. You are going to take that as a true statement. There is a proof behind it, but we don't have to prove it. From postulates, we get theorems. Theorems are proven from the postulate. We will be proving most theorems in this class. But postulates, no. There are two postulates here. The segment addition postulate and the angle addition postulate. They are separate. I combine them because they have the same definition. The segment addition postulate and the angle addition postulate. The definition is the sum of the parts equals the whole. The only reason why they're separate is because they're separate shapes. You have a line and you have an angle. They both have the same meaning. The sum of the parts equals the whole. What does the word sum mean? When you hear the word sum, what are you thinking of?
Addition.
What is a segment?
A line.
So we're going to take a line. We're going to break it up into pieces. We're going to add those pieces together. And it's going to give us the whole thing. So when we add all the parts, it's going to equal the whole. That's it. In the angle addition postulate, same exact thing. Here's an example of the segment addition postulate. You have line segment AC. AC has been broken up by B. So you have AB and BC. AB plus BC is going to equal AC. This piece plus that piece equals the whole thing. Is this difficult?
No.
Is it hard to add?
No.
What usually comes with addition?
Subtraction.
Is it hard to subtract?
No.
No. But again, we do everything in fours. So every time we add, we're going to subtract, multiply, and divide as well. They are not in the directions. They're not going to tell you to use the angle addition postulate or to use the segment addition postulate. They're going to show you to use one or the other. How do they show you that you need to use it? They're going to give you a segment broken up into pieces. If you have a line segment broken up into pieces, typically you're going to use the segment addition postulate to solve your answer. The angle addition postulate is the same thing. You have an angle. It is broken up into pieces. Angle ABC is broken up into ABD and CBD. So that ABD plus CBD equals ABC. This is when it becomes very important that you know how to name things in this classroom because you're then going to have to be able to read them. Angle ABD plus angle CBD equals angle ABC. The sum of the parts equals the whole. Alright, now get your worksheet out from last class. That's all the notes, guys. That's all this is. Yes. Yes. If at any point you lose your worksheets in this classroom, they will be posted on Skyward. You just have to print a new one out and do it. When we get to worksheets, I like to do a couple of them with you so you have some examples, and then you do the rest. With the worksheets, the part that's going to hurt you the most are the directions. A lot of you don't like to read directions in this class. The directions change, the directions tell you exactly what to solve for. Whenever you're done answering a question, always go back to the directions and make sure you answered the correct question. This set of directions says solve for x. This set of directions says solve for the indicated length. So they change. All right. And number one, what is the picture of? A line segment. So what do you assume we're going to use to solve number one when it says solve for x? Adriana, where's Adriana? Oh, there's two, isn't there? Is there two Adrianas? Is it spelled differently? Do you spell it differently? A-D-R-I-A-N-A? Is it spelled the same? Gosh dang it. I don't have a last name on here. This is Adriana G. Alright, Adriana. It says solve for x. That's it. That's the whole direction.
What are we going to use to solve for x? I'll give you a hint. We just took notes on it. Did you title your notes?
Yes.
What did you title your notes?
Addition.
What kind of addition? Be very precise. Good. Segment addition what? You're missing one last word. Sorry for the P.
Postulate.
Good. Perfect. Segment addition postulate. You see how it does not tell you to use it? Now it's easy right now. This is the second week of school. And this is technically the first thing I've taught you. So of course we're using the segment addition postulate. But as the year goes on and we just keep adding more postulates and theorems throughout the year, the directions aren't going to change. These directions are it all year long. You're either solving for x or you're solving for an indicated length. But how you solve for it will change all year long. We're just getting more and more and more things to solve for. How do you know how to solve it? The picture tells you how to solve it. That is a line segment. That is a line segment broken up into pieces. That is the definition of the segment addition postulate, where the sum of the parts equals the whole. Therefore, the sum of the parts, here's part, so you have x plus 18, here's another part, plus x plus 21, if I add them together, it's supposed to equal the whole line that they told me was 21. If you can take this picture and create this equation, you have just successfully graduated geometry. You're done. You passed geometry. So how do so many people fail geometry? This, which is not geometry, this is algebra 1. Can we solve this linear equation for x? If you can, you're going to be fine in this class. What's the first thing you do?
Combine like terms.
So you get 2x plus 39 equals 21. What now?
Subtract
39. What's 21 minus 39? Divide by? Not x. So x equals? Can x equal a negative number?
No.
Why not? Just because you feel like it, that means it doesn't? Can x equal a negative number? Can your variable equal a negative number?
No.
Who says x cannot equal a negative number?
They just changed
the model. Why? Why does it have to be positive? Huh?
Isn't that like describing the thing right now?
There's no negative? Isn't you saying no, it can't? It can't or it can? You don't know?
Isn't that describing the link?
Is x describing the link?
No.
Is x the length of FE? No. X is in the expression describing the length of FE. Did we do anything wrong in the math?
No.
And we got a negative. So is it negative okay for the variable?
Yes.
Yes. Trick question, guys. I just like to do that in case you guys think. It's a variable. Variables represent any type of number, positive, negative, decimal, fractions, even imaginary numbers. Now, if x represented the length of FE, could x be negative? Can you have a negative length, a negative distance? No, absolutely not. If x by itself was the length of FE, if this just said FE was X, then X could not be negative. But because FE says X plus 18, negative 9 plus 18 is? 9. Positive 9. So the length is positive. It's impossible to travel a negative distance, so if you get a negative for your answer as a variable, plug it back in and see if it works. Are we done with number one? Is that the answer?
Yes.
Yes. Look, all it says is solve for x. Do we solve for x?
Yes.
We're done. Don't make it harder on yourself. Harder's going to come in number five. Does it say solve for x?
No.
No, it says find VT. What do we need in order to find VT, though? We need x. So we still have to solve for x. Nothing is going to change from up here. We're doing everything exactly the same. We're just adding an extra step, sir.
Wait, so would it be, 2x minus 2 plus 10 and then equals 7x minus 2?
That's it. The sum of the parts equals the whole. Then you just have fun with Algebra 1 again. So 2x plus 8 equals 7x minus 2. I always try to keep my variables positive, so I'm going to subtract 2x to both sides. You get 8 equals 5x minus 2. Add 2, 10 equals 5x. Divide by 5, x equals 2. Are you done?
No.
Why?
Yeah, we need to have that. Oh, wait, no.
You gotta find VT.
Yeah, buddy.
To which one? To this?
Yeah.
Is this VT?
Yes.
That's VU. What's VT? You can plug it into this and then just add the 10, or you just plug it into this one. This is VT. Doesn't this go from B to T? So VT. Either one is going to give you the same answer, though.
I'm going to plug it into the 7x minus 2. My x was 2, so it's 7 times 2 minus 2, which is 14 minus 2. Your answer is 12. Is this doable?
Yes.
Now look at number 9. Number 9 is not labeled for you, is it?
Again, this is why we learn how to name things, so that we can read it. It says find x, so I'm done as soon as I find x. There's your directions. Find x.
If that lowercase m means the measure of, if the measure of QRS equals 177x minus 1, the measure of URS is 1 plus 149x, and the measure of angle QRU is 26 degrees. So they gave you all the pieces, they just didn't put it where it goes. The best thing I can tell you what to do with this is to actually put it where it goes. So angle QRS, QRS is the whole angle. It's the whole thing. They told me this was 177x minus 1. The whole thing. Then they said angle URS. URS is this piece. This piece is 1 plus 149x. And angle QRU is 26. Now do you see which ones are your parts and which one is your whole?
Yeah.
Set up your equation and add them. This is a part, 26 plus 1 plus 149x equals 177x. Minus 1. This was a part. This was a part. And you're adding them to equal the whole. Combine like terms. What's 26 plus 1?
7.
Subtract 149x from both sides. Now, in this class, you are not allowed to use a calculator unless it's something you're being timed on, meaning a quiz or a test. So if you can't subtract this in your head, bust out the old-fashioned way. 177 minus 149. We all remember how to subtract that way. You learn in elementary school. Start the crossing out. There you go. It's really not that difficult, and it really doesn't take that much time, but it will increase your knowledge and your strength and how fast you are able to add, subtract, multiply, and divide. Don't get lazy. Add 1 to both sides. You get 28 equals 28x. Divide by 28. X equals 1. Are you done? Go back to the directions.
Yes.
That's it. That's all they said was find x. Be careful, number 11 does not say find x. It says find the measure of angle PQB. PQB is right here. So when you find x, you are then going to plug it back into PQB to get your answer. Questions? Yes. If you can fit your work on this piece of paper, I'm fine with that. Sir? All right, I'm going to come back there and help you then. 20 minutes, I'm going to give you to work on this worksheet. Huh? Yes. Twenty-two minutes, because I went past.
Am I supposed to go home and do it? I don't got one paper.
You can look off of somebody else who's just have it written down, that we don't have to read this so we go home. I ran out, I don't have anyone, so come up here and work with somebody, and then we get home and start scattering.
Thank you.
Marquez? Yes, you. Where's your office?
Why we do it?
Thank you.
I do it for the
turn up. You need to go see your guidance counselor. Building 2 FLD. Number 2's on the board.
Coffees, shakes, and drinks. Ain't no thing, you the man. Yeah, that's what they say. Aw, Kevin, thank you so much. We love you. That's right. You the champ. The drink run champ.
Welcome to McDonald's. How can I help you?
Own the drink run, Kevin. Own it. Get any size iced coffee for $1.59 or any size soft drink for $1. Limited time only. Prices and participation may vary. A la carte only. Excludes cold brew coffee.
Now at Speedway, grab any three drinks from the cooler and get 1,000 bonus Speedy Rewards points. So get one for you and two to share, or just keep all three for yourself. Restrictions apply. The convenience stores of Speedway.
And I'll wait all night till Santa comes to wake me from my dreams. Oh, it's that Christmas to me. I see the children play outside like angels in the snow. My mom and daddy share a kiss under the mistletoe. And we'll cherish all these simple things wherever we may be. That's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. Hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why is that Christmas to me? Oh, why is that Christmas to me?
Do it both ways, and then I'll come check
it out. Jenny was hosting a Junior League party.
Problems on this worksheet, this is as hard as they can make this type of problem. Giving you two expressions, giving you positives and negatives, giving you answers for your variables that are negative, that is the hardest way they can make this type of problem.
the whole angle. Look at the picture. What's the biggest angle you see? The EO. So that's the whole angle. So everything has to equal that. So that means 9x minus 1 plus 113 equals... Is that what the problem was? We're setting it up right?
Yeah.
All right.
As a small business owner, you make every dollar count. So what could you do with $10? Could turn 500 strangers into 500 kitchens at VistaPrint.com. Because right now, you'll get 500 high-quality custom business cards for only $9.99. That's less than 2 cents per card. And VistaPrint, your satisfaction is absolutely guaranteed. So what are you waiting for? Just click the banner now or go to VistaPrint.com/Pandora. That's VistaPrint.com/Pandora.
Buying a home is a glad moment, full of emotion. Space Coast Credit Union is there for you during moments like these. You can feel confident that we deliver trusted financial solutions with your individual banking needs in mind. For instance, we offer low rates on home loans with no hidden costs and great service for the life of the loan. Space Coast Credit Union, your life, your financial watchdog. SCCU is an equal housing lender, federally insured by NCUA. Visit SCCU.com.
Whatever is not done, you now must do at home. If, and utilize this, guys, people were texting me all weekend long. If you get stuck on something, do not take a picture of a problem that is blank and say, I don't get it, because I won't respond. But if you take a picture of a problem that you have worked out, and you're stuck on, and you don't know if it's right, or you don't know where you went wrong, take a picture of it, text it to me, I will work it out, or tell you exactly where you went wrong, and send it back. Okay? That is true for any classwork, worksheet, or homework. That's where you guys are supposed to mess up. That's where you're supposed to ask questions. When we get to the quiz and the test, you are no longer supposed to be messing up or asking me questions. So take advantage now. When you're done with this worksheet, you are going to staple it right on top of the notes that we just took. So this worksheet is going to be folded in half and stapled right here on top. Just one staple right in the corner. That way it's quick, easy. If I ask to see it, you can just unfold it, show me both sides are done, and we're good. Now, before we start the next set of notes, I'm going to give you 30 seconds. So you need to turn to page 8 in your notebook. Page 8. You're going to have 30 seconds to write down one fact. One. All I need is one. That's why I'm only giving you 30 seconds. And it's your fact. So you're not talking. You're 100% silent during this. One fact that you know or remember about slope. One. Anything that you can recall about slope. Just one fact. All I need. To go around your table, and everybody's going to say what their one fact was. If, when somebody says what their one fact was, it is different than the fact you have down, you're going to write it down.
If it's the same, obviously you don't have to write it down. So at the end of 1 minute, everybody that's sitting at the same table is going to have the same list of facts about slope. Correct? All right, we're going to start with the person in the front left corner of each group. So everybody's sitting in this table. Okay? 1 minute. Ready, go. Go. But our next step is everybody's going to stand up, and then I'm randomly, not now, going to call on people using Class Dojo. If I call on you, you tell me one fact that you have written down. When somebody says their fact, if you have the same thing, you put a check mark next to it. If you do not have it on in your notes, you write it down. So everybody, when somebody says a fact, is either putting a check mark or writing it down. Right? By the end of this, the whole class is going to have the same list of facts about slope. If you're questionable on whether that's a true fact about slope or not, just wait for them to finish, and then I'll acknowledge whether it's a true fact about slope or not. Okay? Most likely it will be, or I'll at least be able to stretch it into a true fact. Alright, everybody stand up. Diane? Where's Diane?
Me?
Where? Diane? Back there. Diana, tell me one fact about slope.
The equation for slope is
Make That's sure you slope. Sign up.
Alright. She said the equation of slope is y equals mx plus b. If you have that, put a check mark next to it. If you don't, write it down, and if you have this for the equation of slope, erase it, because this is that is the slope-intercept form of a line. Yes, it has slope in it. Yes, we use it a lot. It is not the equation for slope. Luke! Where's Luke? There's two Lukes. Let's see which Luke. Luke, champion. Who's that?
Me.
All right, Luke.
Rise over run.
Rise over run. Melanie? Where's Melanie? Melanie, go ahead. You don't have anything new? Alright, so here goes. If you don't have anything new to contribute to the class, you sit down. That's because we only had the... That means, if you are sitting down, from now on, everything that is said aloud, you are then writing, because you do not have it. Does that make sense? Why is some of your group standing and some of your group sitting? Everybody's supposed to have the same stuff. Why do we not have all the same stuff? Same thing over there. Why are you standing and they're sitting? You have 1 minute to get all the same list. All right. What do you got?
Oh, okay. Exponential growth is increasing.
Yeah, that's not slope. That's exponent. That's way beyond slope, but good job. Growth and decay. What do you got? What'd you say? It can be a negative. Yes. Slope can be negative. Not is, can be. It can be. Can be. Which makes it negative. That's a bad error. Negative slopes go down. Alright. Good list. Good list. Now, here is your slope notes. The definition of slope. Yes. The definition of slope is the change in the vertical distance over the change in the horizontal distance. Which is rise over run. The triangle is delta. Delta means the change in. So the change in y over the change in x. The slope formula, which is not y equals mx plus b, the slope formula is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. It's your y's over your x's. That's what we just did?
Yeah.
Yes. To find slope given 2 points on a graph, you are going to subtract your y's over your subtracted x's. Rise over run. There's 4 types of slope. One of them is a positive slope. Luke V, what's another slope? You have positive, you have what? And then you have, can you keep going?
Neutral.
Constant. Is that, there's positive, there's negative, there's a total of 4, so there's 2. Can anybody name another one? Which thing? No.
What?
Constant? No.
Then when it goes back?
0. Positive, negative, 0. What's the last one?
Negative, positive.
Good morning, Titans. All executive interns, please meet Ms. Korda in the cafeteria at 9:08. And teachers, at this time, please turn your TVs to channel 2 for the morning announcements.
Positive, negative, 0, and undefined. Almost everything in a math class can be read from left to right or right to left, except for slope. Slope has to be read from left to right. What is your line doing as you read it from left to right? If the line is going up, it's increasing. That is a positive slope. If the line is going down, it's decreasing. That is a negative slope. A horizontal line has a slope of 0, and a vertical line has an undefined slope.
We're not saying it doesn't have a slope, it's just undefined. Alright, the last little bit is the equation of a line in slope-intercept form, which is y equals mx plus b. Y and x are coordinates of a point on the graph. M, the lowercase m, stands for slope, and the b is your y-intercept. We'll be dealing with slopes a lot this year. Slopes will help us to determine what kind of shape we have. If two sides are parallel, if two sides are perpendicular. Make sure that worksheet is done by Thursday, or no, this is Monday, Wednesday. I'm going to grade it on Wednesday. If you don't have it, it's in Skyward. If you're done with the notes, you can go ahead and pack up. Yeah, I don't grade it on accuracy because you can text me and get the answer.
Last year was big.
On how to